10 years and more than $10,000. That's what it took for Eva Dunwell and her partner to fall pregnant.
I lost my mum when I was very young, and so it was important for me to be able to be a mum.
After several rounds of IVF, they finally had their daughter, Ariana, in 2019.
Another child is the other dream, but at the moment it's not feasible for us.
Dr. Sunny Barua knows the toll it takes. His new clinic is aiming to offer people the chance to become parents without the extreme price tag.
It can vary from $4,000 to $10,000.
He was among hundreds of experts in Perth today as the Fertility Society of Australia and New Zealand called for a 10-year national plan to boost our plummeting birth rate.
We see that as a big economic challenge, but we also see that people are delaying their fertility.
40 pieces of legislation is too much for Australia. It makes it complex for the providers of care and adds to the cost for the users.
That means lower costs, more access, more lower income families, more babies.
It's set to put pressure on Hunt's successor, Mark Butler, who says the government would carefully consider the report once it's finalised and published. Each year, around 20,000 babies are born in Australia through IVF to parents with a lot of love to give. That's priceless. Francesca Denuccio, 7 News.